Hi everyone, this is Aaron from Paramount Search Marketing. I am one of the search marketing consultants at Paramount and I'm here to show you guys how to get started with your own Google Places page. Now, a Google Places page is basically a dedicated page for your business that will show up in search engine result pages more often than not on the first page for localized searches that are based around your service and your location. So basically this tutorial was to show you guys exactly how to get started with Google Places and how to put together your own Places page. So I'll just show you an example of what a Google Places page might look like within a search engine result page. So here I've searched for a service and within an area, so window cleaning St. George, and directly in the center of this result page is a Places page listing right there. So basically it shows the company name, the address of the company, the telephone number, and the trading hours, and there's also the option for a user to write a review based on their experience with the business. There's also a small screen grab of the location of the business within a Google Maps screen grab there. So I'll just click through to the page to show you guys exactly what it looks like. Okay, so basically there's all the essential pieces of information associated with this business, including their name, location, phone number, website URL, the categories that the business falls into, things like trading hours and their rating, and also a description that the owner has put in themselves as well. Over there on the right is the pin again on an enlarged screenshot of Google Maps to show their location. There's also the option to click here through to Street View to have a look at exactly where the business is located. There's also some more details here, such as the radius of the area served, the email, and some payment information there as well. As we move a little bit further down the page, there's options to upload photos and videos for the business. There's also user reviews here. In this case, there has been no reviews. Other related places, and also a bit more about this place, and these are just associated links from around the web. So that's pretty much the gist of what a Places page looks like. Now I'm going to pause this video and jump into the account of this Places page and show you exactly how they got to this stage. Okay, so the first thing to take note of here is that you do need to have a Google account created to be able to put together a Places page. So to do this is pretty simple. Just go to google.com/accounts and you'll be served with this page here, which you have the option to sign in with your existing Google account, or you can create an account here. So that's just as simple as following the steps to do so. So we already have an existing account, so I'm just going to sign in here. Okay, so here's the Google Accounts backend. I'm not going to go into anything else on this page here except this Google Places link over here on the left. Okay, so this is the Google Places backend. So it shows your dashboard here, which is the main thing that you want to be looking at here, which shows all of your existing Places pages and businesses. So we already have an active Places page here that's not yet published, but we're looking to have that published soon, and I'll go into that a little bit later why it's not. But you can have more than one Places page for separate businesses though. So you cannot have more than one Places page for a single business. But if you do have more than one business, you can add another business, which is over here. So first things first, you need to choose your country and enter your phone number. So Just for example's sake, I'm just going to put a generic number in here, because what Google does is if you put a phone number in here that it already has associated information for that phone number, it will basically go out and grab as much information that it knows about your business and kind of fill in the fields for you. But if you put in a number that it doesn't recognize or doesn't have business information for, then you'll start from scratch. Okay, so the first fields that you have to fill out up here is your company name. So I'm just gonna type that in. Then you have your street address, your town, your state, and postcode. And you'll see as you fill these fields out, the map will auto-generate a PIN based on your location over here. Then you've got email address that you're free to fill in, website URL, that is already there. Here is where you can add a description of your business. This is where you can write anything that you want to write about your business, but just keep in mind that there is a 200 character limit. So I'll just skip that one for now. Here is where you can add the categories that your business falls under. So Google has predefined categories, or alternatively you can add your own. So I'll just jot in search engine optimization and social media strategies. So you can have up to 5 categories, but I'll just leave it at 3 for this example's sake. The further you move down, you have service areas and location settings. So basically this will be dependent on how your business actually functions. So do you have a physical storefront that customers come to your business, or alternatively do you serve customers at their location? So if you do have a fixed storefront, then I would check no, but if you do service customers at the locations, Google wants to know a bit more about that, such as how far are you willing to travel, what is your service area. So say for example Caringbah, and I'm willing to service, you know, within a 20 kilometer radius, it will then generate that radius on the map and show users that land on that page. Alternatively, you can add the list of areas here, but I would say that is probably a little more time intensive than just providing the radius there. The further that you move down the page, you have hours of operation, so you can prefer not to specify these, but I think the more that you fill in on the page, the better. The more information that you're giving customers, the better. So you can change the times here, and you can change the days that you do and you don't work, so it's all pretty simple. Down here you have how customers can pay at your business. So there's cash, check, MasterCard, Visa and PayPal, all very popular ways of making a payment. Then below that is the more interactive stuff here, so photos and videos. So you can upload up to 10 photos for your business, but they must comply with the photo submission guidelines. So you might just want to click that link and have a quick read of what Google expects when you are uploading photos. If you want to take it even a little bit further, you can also add your own company videos. So that's just as simple as pasting a YouTube URL here. So below that is any additional details, things like parking, anything else that you want to add to your places page. So anything that you write in this box here will become this title here, and anything in here will be the answer to that there. So once you've filled out all of your business's information on the page, it's time to then submit the information to Google. And basically here it prompts you and says, how would you like to validate your listing? And in most cases, Google will send you a physical postcard in the mail that will arrive within 2 to 3 weeks. based on the address that you've given them. And this is a foolproof way for them to make sure that you are the business owner and that you can respond by being at that physical location. So once you see this screen, just click finish and that will be done. I'm just going to pause this video and head back to the dashboard to wrap up this tutorial. Okay, so here I am back at the Google Places dashboard. And what this shows is a listing here of the Google Places page that we've just edited. As you can see here, the status is set at needs action. So what that means is we're still awaiting the arrival of our postcard, as Google estimates it would be 2 to 3 weeks. But as you receive that postcard, you will have a PIN that appears on that, that Google's provided you to verify your Google Places page. And this is the best way for them to completely verify that you are in fact the owner of that business. And once you fill in the PIN here, you have claimed your Google Places page for your business and it is ready to be published. Once it is published, you will then appear in search engine result pages for localized search terms that are associated with where your business is located and what your business does. Okay, so that's the end of this tutorial. I hope that you guys have found some value in it and that you can go out and get started as soon as possible in putting together your own Google Places page for your own business and drive more visitors and customers to your website. Please be sure to check out the other videos and tutorials in Paramount's YouTube channel. If not, please visit us at www.paramountsearchmarketing.com.au.